Good day everyone, this is Echo419, and today we're taking a look at the paint job I did for a friend's 3D printed Mini Nuke from the Fallout games. Let's begin. I wanted to first start off with a disclaimer that I did not personally 3D print this, one of my friends did. I cannot direct you to the download link because I don't know where exactly my friend downloaded the file from. For this project, all I was asked to do was to paint it, with my choice of a clean look, a weathered and used appearance, or somewhere in between. With that disclaimer out of the way, let's dive on in. There are two variations to the Fallout Mini Nuke. The first appears in Fallout 3 and New Vegas, as seen here. The second variation is in the games Fallout 4 and 76, as shown here. The design of the STL file is instantly recognizable as to what it is, although it is not a direct copy of either variation. The bottom section with the stabilizer fins closely resembles the Fallout 3 and New Vegas variant, whereas the upper section and the nose looks more like the version from Fallout 4 and 76. Given this, I took some artistic liberties when it came to how I chose which sections got painted what color. In both versions, the majority of the nuke is either a dark green or an olive drab, with red on the stabilizer fins and tip of the nose, and a yellow stripe around the main body. I opted for silver on the thruster and stabilizer fin ring to break up the monotony of being primarily a single color. I added red on the fins in the same manner as the Fallout 3 and New Vegas variant due to the structural similarities. The warning triangles were made using simple masking techniques, with the black laid down first and the yellow sprayed on top. On both game versions, the yellow stripe around the body is actually higher up and closer to the nose, but on the version I painted there are two prominent ridges around the middle of the main body. This made masking easier because I had a nice guide to follow, so I decided to make that middle section yellow instead. The inside of the thruster nozzle section is painted in a dark gray. Since the thruster nozzle has to withstand high heat to deliver the munition to the target, I figured a dark gray paint would show that it's made of a different material. The interior of the nuke is painted silver to show that it was most likely constructed of a type of steel, and there would be no need to paint the bare steel on the inside of the munition. The nose section screws off, and I painted the threads and interior silver as well. I chose to paint the red section just like the Fallout 4 and 76 design. A minor detail that I left is the mix of overspray along the bottom edge of the nose between the silver and green paints. This gives the look of wear and being handled. Overall, I was originally aiming for a clean look with crisp lines, but it didn't turn out perfectly. I still think it's fine because it tells the story that the munition was probably being handled a lot and then later placed into storage. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time. DJ, play my outro.